our channel Class 5 Community. So today we will be going to do about mean or average value of AC. We have already completed a lecture on the introduction of the AC, right? So now let's move on and derive this mean or average value of AC. Whenever we see the word average, we means that there will be some items. We will do the summation of that items divided by the total number of the items, right? But here we will do a different approach. The approach is that, see, let's first define it. It is defined as that value of AC which would send same amount of current through a circuit in half cycle that is sent by steady current in the same through the same circuit. Basically, it says that there will be a value for AC which would provide a amount of charge through a circuit in the half cycle, and it will be similar to the steady current in the same. Okay, so see, we know that half cycle will be pi because our full cycle is 2 pi, right? 2 pi means 360 degree. So our half will be 180 degree, and we know that half cycle for 180 degree is pi. Okay, so if we want to say that a full cycle is T, then our half cycle will be T by 2 then, right? So see, I have written that there is an instantaneous value, so there will be a value of AC. So here is an instantaneous value of alternating current. So we are here doing the alternating current derivation. So it will be I is equal to I naught. I naught is a peak or the maximum current, sine omega t dt. Here we have taken the sine wave, so we are doing the sine omega t dt. Okay, see, the average current in AC. So whenever we know that there will be an average current, that means the delta Q, that means changes in the charges by the change in time. So if we think that this is a curve given, and this is the T1 time and this is the T2 time, so this area will give us the delta Q is equal to T1 to T2 I dt. This is an integration, and our current is the function of the time. We have done in our previous years of knowledge, right? So see, the average current for time varying current will be IAV is equal to T1 to T2 integration I dt by the range. Range means T2 minus T1. So the T2 minus T1 can be written as delta T. So we will take out the delta T like this, and this is the integration from T1 to T2 I dt. So in an IDC, if there is a straight line, that means it is a pure direct current, right? T1 to T2. So I average is always equal to the IDC, right? In the direct current. So let's move on and do the mean average value or mean or average value of AC. So see, we have done T1 to T2 integration I dt by delta Q. And we know that the I, that is our I, is equal to I naught sine omega t dt, right? So we can write this I is equal to I naught sine omega t dt, and our T1 is 0 to T. We are taking this side as a full cycle and this side as a half cycle to make you understand a thing. So we will doing these two things parallelly. Okay, so see, this till this one, it is a first half cycle, and this part is a second half cycle. The red portion is the, that is from 0 to T by 2, and the violet portion is from T by 2 to T. Okay, so see, this is a sinusoidal graph or the waveform which can be represented like this. Okay, now see, I will take the I naught out here by T, and it integrating from 0 to T sine omega T dt. And we know that the equation of the alternating current is I naught sine omega T, right? See, here when it is half cycle, we just change this portion, that is a T. So here it will be T by 2, and in down it will be T by 2 minus 0, because we are taking from 0 to T by 2, that is half cycle. Here we are taking from 0 to T, that is a full cycle. So similarly, we will take out our T by 2 and I naught, so 2 up and 2 by t I naught to, and we integrate from 0 to t by tau sin omega t dt. Okay, now see I naught by t, and we know that sin omega t in integration we get what? Minus cos omega t. And when we do the differentiation of omega t we get, and whenever we solve this we get right omega here. So see, we got minus cos omega t by omega, right? And we will integrate from 0 to t. Similarly here we will get 2 I naught by t omega, we are taking out the omega here, and minus cos omega t dt, and we will integrate from 0 to t by 2. So now we will take out the omega. Here also we took out the omega. We know that now when we put the, wherever there is omega t, we will put the values of the upper limit and the lower limit. So here we put, wherever there will be t, we will put that. So it is cos omega t minus cos 0. And here also it will be cos omega t minus cos 0. So, and we know that omega is equal to 2 pi by t. So 2 pi by t here, 2 pi by t into t, tt gets cut, and we get 2 pi by 2 because it is t by 2. So here we have got cos omega t by 2 minus cos 0 we have got. So it will be 2 pi by 2 minus cos 0. And here also we get that cos 2 pi minus cos 0. So we know that cos 2 pi is 1. So when we solve, 1 minus 1 is 0. So the I average for the full cycle will be 0 then. And here we get cos 2 pi minus cos 0. We get here cos 2 pi by 2 minus cos 0. So 2 and 2 gets cut. So we are left over with cos pi minus cos 0. And we know that cos pi is minus 1. So when we solve this, we get 4 I naught by 4 I naught by t omega. And we know that omega is 2 pi by t. So the t gets up and tt gets cut, right? So tt gets cut and we get 4 I naught by 2 pi. So when we cut 2 and 4, we get 2 I naught pi. And when we solve this, we get 0.637 I naught. When we solve 2 pi, we get 0.637 I naught. So for the full cycle, we got the I average or IM as 0. But for the half cycle, we get 0.637 I naught. See, whenever you will do the full cycle, we know beforehand only that this is a positive half cycle, this is a negative half cycle. So positive and negative, when we solve this, we will get, because a positive half cycle and negative half cycle will nullify each other. So whenever we will do full cycle, we will get 0 as an average. So I did both of them parallelly, so you can get a clear concept. So whenever you will do, try to do parallelly so that you have a clear concept. Okay, now see, when we solve this and we need to write all this, we will write that. That means mean value of AC, which can be written as IM or IV, is 63.7% of the peak value of AC. That means this is 63.7% of the maximum value. Okay, over any half cycle, either it will be positive half cycle or the negative half cycle. But in a complete cycle of AC, the mean value of AC will be 0. Okay, and in the same way, mean value of alternating EMF, which is EM or EAV, you can say EM equal to 2 E naught by pi. You will get this same value, that is the 0.637 E naught for the alternating EMF as well as the alternating current. So this is our mean value of AC for both current and voltage. I hope you all to see you in the next lecture. Till then, be happy and have a great day.
Now is the COVID time. We may encounter many defeats, but we must not be defeated. I hope all of you understood the lecture of today. And thank you for watching.
Wow, that's impressive. You have completed a magic today. For more videos, subscribe. Join our Facebook group and Instagram page for group discussion and live magus videos for exam preparation in an hour. We start at class like community for students to learn from a friend in a simple way and support them in their own languages. If you are willing to be that one friend who saves us at the exam night preparation, then please join us by visiting classfly.in.